Hi, welcome back. In the previous lesson, we learned how to configure anti-framework core in a .NET project. Also, in the previous lesson, we mentioned we'll be using SQL Server for our anti-framework core course. In this lesson, I would like to show you how to install and configure SQL Server and SQL Server Management Studio before diving into anti-framework core. I am going to open SQL Server download page. When I scroll down in the Microsoft official SQL Server download page, I see several options here. We'll be choosing SQL Server 2022 Express because it's free, lightweight, and has everything we need to practice for anti-framework core course. That is why no need to choose the complex one. I will be clicking download now link. It has been downloaded successfully. It asks permission. Let's click yes. And here we'll be going with the basic option. Accept. And this default path should be here. And it showed to you download size and minimum free space for it. I will click the install. The installation will take some time. You need to wait till it ends. It has been downloaded successfully. But here, as you see, there is some connection string that we need to store in somewhere. It is so crucial because later, most probably, you can't find out it easily. That is why you need to click the copy and save it somewhere. I will paste it here and close my sticky note. And here it shows the log folder and media folder also and show the versions. Here we need to do one more thing. Since it has been downloaded and installed successfully SQL Server, we need to install SQL Server Management Studio also. Because SQL Server Management Studio gives us user interface to manage database. It is crucial and essential part for us also. That is why we'll install SQL Server Management Studio. And here, if I click install SQL Server Management Studio, it redirects me to the installation page. If you scroll down here, you will see SQL Server Management Studio 21. I will click and install. While installing SQL Server Management Studio, expect you to do some configuration. And here, that could be crucial for you. I would like to choose English version, but you can choose the another version, another language pack also. Now, I will keep everything as a default and I will click install. The installation will take some time. We need to wait till it ends. When installation done, you should be able to see same message what I'm seeing here now. We can click OK. Let's open our SQL Server Management Studio, what we have installed. If you write down SSMS, you should be able to see this icon. That is a new icon of the SQL Server Management Studio. Here, it shows us to connect with our Microsoft account, GitHub account, or we can create new account. But I will be skipping this right now. We'll add accounts later. If there is previous versions that already installed on your machine, we'll ask to import configuration from there. I will ask click the don't import. Now, here's my SQL Server Management Studio installed and configured successfully. To be able to access your database, you should provide your server name here. If I click the drop-down, it shows me browse more. In the local server section, I will click the plus button and there is SQL Server that's already installed on my machine. I will show it to you one more thing. And there is also same server you can use by providing manually. It is same to access same things, but I will click select this one. I will disconnect it and I will try to connect database again. I will provide the SQL Server name, what we have already stored in our sticky note. I will click to connect. Yes, that is same. In this lesson, we saw how to install and configure SQL Server Express and set up SQL Server Management Studio. And also, we noted down connection string, which we'll be using in the next lesson to connect our application to the database. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the lesson and learned something valuable today. If you found this helpful, please subscribe, leave a like, and share it with other developers who might benefit.